So you can provide us with some sweet interstitial music, some sweet tunes in between poems. Thumbs up, thumbs down? Okay, I think your thumb is up. Cool. Yeah. Hey everybody, I'm Nan Voss, and welcome to the 6th annual Poetry Out Loud Finals at Eureka High School. You can clap, it's fine. I'd like to introduce a few people before we get started. First of all, Ms. Tatro is our accuracy judge. She's checking to make sure everybody says the right things. We have some awesome community members as our actual judges. So David Holper works at CR and is a known poet, and he's very well-versed in this particular competition. Evan Needham is an actor and director himself in the community, and Donna Doherty, former Eureka High School English teacher and now consultant in other areas of English. It's pretty, really cool. And then Mr. Stiano is up there, keeping score of things. and Darnell will be providing sweet tunes for us in between the poems. So we're going to start out today with just some calibrating so the judges can get on track. We have two calibrators for you, and then you can have a moment to talk and to check your scores to make sure you're kind of on the same page. That will be a moment for you to play music, Darnell, just so you know. You can just like wave your hands and be like, oh, and I'll do the same thing. All right. So let's start with Isaac Young.
Jamie. Last night, when the moon slipped into my attic room as an oblong of light, I sensed she'd come to commiserate. It was August. She traveled with a small valise of darkness and the first few stars returning to the northern sky. And my roommate seemed to have missed her. She pretended an interest in the bookcase while other objects stirred, as in a rock pool with unexpected life. Strings of beads in their green bowl gleamed, the paper-crowded desk, the books, too, appeared inclined to open and confess. Being sure the moon harbored some intention, I waited, watched for an age or cool gaze shift, first toward a flower sketch, pinned at the far wall, then glide down to recline along the pinewood floor before I'd had enough. Moon, I said, we're both scarred now. Are they quite beyond you, the simple words of love? Say them. You are not my mother. With my mother, I waited unto death.
And Christina.
Springs. We are all ventricle, spine, lung, larynx, and gut, clavicle and nape, what lies forked in an open palm. We are follicle and temple. We are ankle, arch, sole, pore and rib, pelvis and root, and tongue. We are wishbone and gland and molar and lobe. We are hippocampus and exposed nerve and cornea. Areola, pigment, melanin and nails. Varicose, cellulite. Divining rod, sinew and tissue, saliva and silt. We are blood and salt, clay and aquifer. We are breath and flame and stratosphere. Palimpsest and bibelote and cloisonné fine lines. Marigold, hydrangea, and dimple. Nightlight, satellite, and stubble, a constellation of freckles and specters and miracles and lashes. Both bent and erect, we are all give and give back. We are Volta and Girder. Make an incision in our nectary and painted ladies sail forth, riding the backs of a warm wind, plumed with love and things like love. Crack us down to the marrow and you may find us full of cicada husks and sand dollars and salted maple taffy. Wary of welding together our daydreams, all sweet tea, razor blades, carbon, and patchwork quilts of good God, and Lord have mercy. Our hands remember how to turn the earth before we do. Our intestinal fortitude, not in our foundation. This comes first as a suckling, swaddled song sung at the cosmos breast. You want to know what women are made of? Open wide and find out.
So we'll just take a moment for the judges to chat. So this is a good time for music if you have some, Darnell.
I cannot play.
You cannot play anything right now?
No.
Okay. That's fine too. Well, you can keep working that out. So now we'll keep going with our competition. Judges, after each person, I'll come down and get your sheets from you and put your scores in the computer. All right, first up is Kayla Citadel.
Cheese and fried. I want to wander the aisles, my heart's supermarket stocked high as cholesterol. I want to die wearing a sweatsuit. I want to live forever in a Christmas sweater, a teddy bear nursing off the front. I want to write a check in the express lane. I want to scrape my driveway clean myself early. Before anyone's awake, that'll put him to shame. I want to see what the sun sees before it tells the snow to go. I want to be the only black person I know. I want to drive two blocks. Why walk? I want love and stuff. I want to cut my sutures myself. I want to jog down to the river and make it my bed. I want to walk its muddy banks and make me a withdrawal. I tried jumping in, found it frozen. I'll go home, I guess, to my rooms where the moon changes and shines like television.
Next up is Isaac Weatherby.
Dear love, he is strong and bold, and he cares not what comes after. His words ring sweet as a chime of gold, and his eyes are lit with laughter. He is jubilant as a flag unfurled, though a girl should not forget him. My own dear love, he is all my world, and I wish I'd never met him. My love, he's mad, and my love, he's fleet, and a young wild wood thing bore him. The ways are fair to his wandering feet, and the skies are sunlit for him. As sharply sweet to my heart he seems, as the fragrance of acacia. My own dear love, he is all my dreams, and I wish he were in Asia. My love runs by like a day in June, and he makes no friends with sorrows. He'll tread his galloping rigadoon in the pathway of the morrows. He'll live his days where the sunbeam starts, nor could storm or wind uproot him. My own dear love, he's on my heart, and I wish somebody'd shoot him.
Try to praise the mutilated world by Adam Segajewski. Try to praise the mutilated world. Remember June's long days and wild strawberries, drops of rosé wine, the nettles that methodically overgrow the abandoned homesteads of exiles. You must praise the mutilated world. You watch the stylish yachts and ships. One of them had a long trip ahead of it while salty oblivion awaited others. You've seen the refugees going nowhere. You've heard the executioners sing joyfully. You should praise the mutilated world. Remember the moments when we were together in a white room and the curtain fluttered? Return in thought to the concert where music flared. You gathered acorns in the park in autumn, and leaves eddied over the earth's scars. Praise the mutilated world, and the gray feather a thrush lost, and the gentle light that strays and vanishes. And returns.
Next is Anya Furman.
Advice to a Prophet by Richard Wilbur. When you come, as you soon must, to the streets of our city, mad-eyed from stating the obvious, not proclaiming our fall, but begging us, in God's name, to have self-pity. Spare us all word of the weapons, their force and range, the long numbers that rocket the mind. Our slow, unreckoning hearts will be left behind, unable to fear what is too. too strange. Nor shall you scare us with talk of the death of the race. How should we dream of this place without us? The sun, mere fire, the leaves untroubled about us, a stone look on the stone's face. Speak of the world's own change, though we cannot conceive of an undreamt thing we know to our cost. How the dreamt cloud crumbles, the vines are blackened by frost, how the view alters. We could believe, if you told us so, that the white-tailed deer will slip into perfect shade or perfectly shy. The lark avoid the reaches of our eye, the jack pine lose its knuckled grip on the cold ledge, and every torrent bird, as Xanthus once, its gliding trout stunned in a twinkling, what should we be without the dolphin's arc, the dove's return, these things in which we have seen ourselves and spoken? Ask us, prophet, how we shall call our nature's forth when that live tongue is all dispelled, that glass obscured or broken, in which we have said the rose of our love and the clean horse of our courage, in which beheld the singing locust of the soul unshelled in all we mean or wish to mean. Ask us whether with the world this rose our hearts shall fail us, come demanding, whether there shall be lofty or long standing when the bronze annals of the oak tree close.
Under the Vulture Tree by David Bottoms. We have all seen them circling pastures, have looked up from the mouth of a barn, a pine clearing, the fences of our own backyards, and have stood amazed by the one slow wingbeat, the endless dihedral drift. But I have never seen so many so close, hundreds. Every limb of the dead oak feathered black, and I cut the engine, let the river grab the John Boat and pull it toward the tree. The black leaves shined, the pink fruit blossomed red, ugly as a human heart. Then, as I passed under their dream, I saw for the first time its soft countenance, the raw fleshy jowls wrinkled and generous, like the faces of the very old who have grown to empathize with everything. And I drifted away from them, slow, on the pull of the river, reluctant, looking back at their roost, calling them what I'd never called them, what they are, those dwarfed transfiguring angels who flock to the side of the poison fox, the mud turtle crushed on the shoulder of the road, who prey on leave graves of the anonymous lost with mercy enough to consume us all and give us wings.
Thank you. Statues by Sarah Lindsay. Our general was elsewhere, but we drowned. While he rested, he shipped us home with the bulk of his spoils that had weighed his army down. The thrashing storm that caught us cracked the holes and made us offerings to the seafloor, a rain of statues, gold, and men. Released from service, done with war, the crash and hiss muted. We fell through streams of creatures whose lives were their purpose. We settled with treasure looted from the temples of rubbled Athenian Greece. Among us, bronze and marble gods and goddesses mourned without grace, dodged by incurious fish. Their power was never meant to buoy us. Our pleasures were incidental gifts, but shaken by their radiance in our dust, we had given them our voices. Their faces, wings, and limbs lie here with our sanded bones and motionless devices. Little crabs attempt to don wings set with agate and amethyst, and then an octopus, seeking an hour of rest, find shelter in our brain cases. So we are still of use.
Next is Dimitris Stephanakis.
Yeah, that's good. All right. 1969 by Alex Dimitrov. The summer everyone left for the moon, even those yet to be born and the dead. You can't vacation here, but met us all there, by the veil between worlds. The number one song in America was in the year 2525. Because who has ever lived in the present when there's so much of the future to continue without us? How the best lover won't need to forgive you, and surely take everything off your hands without having to ask, without knowing your name. No matter the number of times you married or didn't. Your favorite midnight movie. The cigarettes. You couldn't give up. Wanting to kiss other people you shouldn't, and now to forever be kissed by the earth. In the earth. With the earth. When we all briefly left it. To look back at each other from above, shocked by how bright even our pain is. Running wildly beside us like an underground river. In whatever language is good for. A sign, a message, left up there that reads, here, men from the planet Earth first set foot upon the moon. July 1969 AD. We came in peace for all mankind, then returned to continue the war.
Slugs in their lair, the bees are stirring, birds are on the wing, and winter, slumbering in the open air, wears on his smiling face a dream of spring. And I, the while, sole and busy thing, nor honey make, nor pair, nor build, nor sing. Yet, will I kin the banks where amaranths blow, have traced the fount when streams of nectar flow? Bloom, O ye amaranths, bloom for who ye may. behind a sieve, and hope without an object cannot live. So many things seem filled with the intent to be lost that their loss is no disaster. Lose something every day, except the fluster of lost door keys, that hour badly spent. The art of losing isn't hard to master. And practice losing farther, losing faster. Places and names and where you were meant to travel, none of these will bring disaster. I lost my mother's watch, and look, my last or next to last of three loved houses went. The art of losing isn't hard to master. I lost two cities, lovely ones, and vaster. Some realms I owned, two rivers, a continent. I missed them, but it wasn't a disaster. Even losing you, a joking voice, a gesture I love, I shan't have lied. It's evident the art of losing's not too hard to master, though it may look like, write it, like disaster.
And last in our first round is Marina Benson.
What thy blemishes amend, if so I could. I washed thy face, but more defects I saw, and rubbing off a spot, still made a flaw. I stretched thy joints to make thee even, yet still thou runst more hobbling than is meet. In better dress to trim thee was my mind, but not save homespun cloth in the house I find. In this array, mongst vulgars mayst thou roam. In critics' hands beware thou dost not come, and take thy way where yet thou art not known. If for thy father asked, say thou hast none. And for thy mother, she, alas, is poor, which caused her thus to send thee out of door.
All right, we're going to roll through it again. Round two, Kayla Sidetong is up.
Triumph Like a Girl by Ada Limon. pity horses best. How they make it all look easy. Like running 40 miles per hour is as fun as taking a nap or grass. I like their lady horse swagger after winning. Ears up, girls, ears up. But mainly, let's be honest, I like that they're ladies. As if this big, dangerous animal is also a part of me. That somewhere inside the delicate skin of my body, there pumps an 8-pound female horse heart. Giant with power, heavy with blood. Don't you want to believe it? Don't you want to lift my shirt and see the huge, beating, genius machine that thinks, no. It knows it's going to come first.
Confessions by Robert Browning. What is he buzzing in my ears? Now that I come to die, do I view the world as a veil of tears? Our reverence, sir, not I. What I viewed there once, what I view again, where the physic bottles stand on the table's edge, is a suburb lane with the wall to my bedside hand. That lane sloped, much as bottles do, from a house you could describe or the garden wall. Is the curtain blue or green to a healthy eye? To mine, it serves for the old June weather, blue above lane and wall. And that farthest bottle labeled ether is the house overtopping all. At a terrace, somewhere near the stopper, there watched for me one June. A girl. I know, sir, it's improper. My poor mind's out of tune. There was a way. You crept very close by the side to dodge eyes in the house. Two eyes, except they styled their house the lodge. What right had a lounger up their lane, but by creeping very close with the good wall's help, their eyes might strain and stretch themselves to O's, yet never catch her and me together. As she left the attic there by the rim of the bottle labeled ether and stole from stair to stair and stood by the rose-wreathed gate, last we loved, sir, used to me. How sad and bad and mad it was, but then how it was sweet.
Up next is Gavin Morgan.
Soiled the other. The field lay fallow, swollen with frost, expectant winter. Mud clung to the edges of our gowns. We had hung back like shadows on the walls of trees and watched. In the little circles that our tapers threw, murdered men rose red in their clanging armor, muttered words that bled through the bars of iron masks. The Lord, who sold us to the glory fields, lied. Trumpets without tongues, we wove lilies into the baskets. When they asked us what we meant by these, we'd say, Mary, Mary, and be still. We lined the baskets on the sill in the barn, where it is always dusk and the cows smell sweet. Now the snow sifts through the trees, dismembered lace, the white dust of angels. Angels. And the ringing of keys that hang in bunches at our waist, and the sound of silk whispering. Whispering. There is nothing in the high windows but swirling snow, the glittering milk of winter. The halls grow chill, the candles flicker. Let them wake who will and think what they want. The Lord has gone with the hunt, and the snow grows thicker. Well, he will keep till spring thaw comes, head, hand, and heart, baskets of wicker, baskets of straw.
Next is Anya Furman.
Listen More by Mary Carr. The devil's tour of hell did not include a factory line where molten lead spilled into mouths held wide, no electric drill spiraling screws into hands and feet, nor giant pliers to lower you into simmering vats. Instead, a circle of light opened on your stuffed armchair whose chintz orchids did not boil and change. And the devil adjusted your new spiked antenna almost delicately with claws curled and lacquered black before he spread his leather wings to leap into the acid green sky. So, your head became a TV hole, a gargoyle mirror, your doppelganger sloppy at the mouth and swollen at the joints, enacted your days in sinuous, slow motion, your lines delivered with a mocking sneer. Sometimes, the frame froze, reversed, began again, the red eyes of a friend. Girl child cowered behind the drapes. Parents alive again and puzzled by this new form. That's why you clawed your way back to this life.
Up next is Rebecca Van Busker.
Sunset by Edith Wharton. Leaguered in fire, the jetty promenade. Sorry, can I start over? Sunset by Edith Wharton. Leaguered in fire, the wild black promontories of the coast extend their savage silhouettes. The sun in universal carnage sets, and halting higher, the motionless storm clouds mask their sullen threats like an advancing mob in sword points penned, that balked yet stands at bay. Mid zenith hangs the fascinated day in wind lustrated hollows crystalline. A wan Valkyrie whose wide pinions shine across the ensanguined ruins of the fray,
and in her hand swings high overhead above the waster of war, the silver torch light of the evening star wherewith to search the faces of the dead. Lagooned in gold seem not those jetty promontories, rather the outposts of some ancient land forlorn, uncomforted of morn, where old oblivions gather the melancholy, unconsoling fold of all things that go utterly to death and mix no more, no more with life's perpetually awakening breath. Shall time not ferry me to such a shore, over such sailless seas, with hope's slain importunities in miserable marriage? Nay, shall not all things be there forgot, save the sea's golden barriers and the black, close-crouching promontories? Dead to all shames, forgotten of all glories, shall I not wander there, a shadow's shade, a specter self-destroyed that... Line. So purged of all remembrance and sucked back into the primal void, that should we on the shore phantasmal meet, I should not know the coming of your feet.
Red, Red Rose by Robert Burns. Oh, my love is like a red, red rose that's newly sprung in June. Oh, my love is like the melody that's sweetly played in tune. So fair art thou, my bonnie lass, so deep in love am I. And I will love thee still, my dear, till our seas gone dry. Till our seas gone dry, my dear, the rocks melt with the sun. I will love thee still, my dear, while the sands of life shall run. And fare thee weel, my only love, and fare thee weel a while. And I will come again, my love, though it were 10,000 miles.
Mansplaining by Jennifer Militello. Dear sir,
air of authority leaves me lost. Eases me from a place of ease. Contracts with my contradictions to take from me a place. Autopilots my autobiography. Frightens my fright. Sighs with my breath. Wins it my race. Your certainty has me curtained. Your nerve has me nervous. Your childhood has me childlike. And your nastiness nests in my belfry like a hawk. You are beyond and above my slice of sky. Peach as a pie, bourbon as its pit. You are spit and vinegar while I sour in my bowl. You bowl me over while I tread lightly on my feet. You walk on water while I sink. You witness me, fisherman, boat on the lake. I struggle and burble and brittle and drop. You wink at me, and I must relate. I close my eyes to erase you. You are written in my lids, a litmus test, a form of layer. God, with 3 days of facial growth and an old bouquet for a face, soap and water for a brain. I have no handsome answer. I have no pillar of salt or shoulder to look over. I have no feather to weigh. I have no bubble to burst. I am less to myself, a character within a drama, a drumbeat, a benevolence of light. All parts of me satiate on sight. Names for an artery or organ. Good night.
Struck the board and cried, "No more, I will abroad." What? Shall I ever sigh and pine? My lines in life are free. Free as the road, loose as the wind, as large as store. Shall I be still in suit? Have I no harvest but a thorn to let me blood, and I restore what I have lost with cordial fruit? Sure, there was wine before my sighs to dry it. There was corn before my tears to drown it. Is the year only lost to me? Have I no bays to crown it? No flowers, no garlands gay? All blasted? All wasted? Not so, my heart, but there is fruit in thou hast hands. Recover all thy side-blown age on double pleasures. Leave thy cold dispute on what's fit and not. Forsake thy cage, thy rope of sands, which petty thoughts have made and made to thee good cable. To enforce and draw, and be thy law. While thou didst wink and wouldst not see, away, take heed, I will abroad, call in thy death's head there, tie up thy fears. He that forbears to suit and serve his need, deserve his load. But as I raved and grew more fierce and wild at every word, methought I heard one calling, child. And I replied, my lord.
And our last competitor is Marina Benson. After Marina, we will have just a few minutes to figure out the scores, and then we'll announce the winners.
Checked tablecloths dissolved in back gardens. Empty deck chairs collected rain. As I took my way to her through traffic, through lilacs stripping blackly behind houses and on curbsides, to pay her the last tribute of a daughter, I thought of something I remembered. I heard once that the body is, or is said to be,
ours is a city of it. One in which every single day the elements begin a journey towards each other that will never, given our weather, fail. The ocean visible in the edges cut by it. Cloud color reaching into air. The lithy storing one and summoning the other. Salt greeting the lack of it at the north wall, and as if that wasn't enough, all of it ending up almost every evening inside our speech. Coast, canal, ocean, river, stream, and now mother. And I drove on, and although the mind is unreliable in grief, at the next cloudburst it almost seemed they could be shades of each other, the way the body is of every one of them. And now they were on the move again. Fog into mist, mist into sea spray, and both into the oily glaze that lay on the railings of the house she was dying in. As I went inside.
All right, before I announce the winners, just to make you wait longer, don't run away, judges, or all competitors will get a group photo with the judges, and then we'll get a photo with the winners as well. All right, so coming in third is Rebecca Van Musker. And coming in second is Anya Furman. And in first place is Marina Benson. They worked very hard. And thank you all for coming out and supporting these young people. We really appreciate it. All right, photo time.